The idea that gay sex is all about getting the penis in the butt is a little oversimplified. There's a lot more you can do with someone's body and enjoy their company and their presence without necessarily having what we would consider gay sex. Step number one, find guys that you want to have sex with. For me, this is the hardest part. We live in an era when apps and websites have kind of dominated the gay dating market. So there's other options as well. There are gay bars, your local gay laundromat, there's your local gay gym. You have a lot of options. Step two, you have to talk about sex. Because oftentimes we are each other's teachers. You know, your parents don't normally teach you how to do this. A lot of gay men learn how to do it from porn, which is problematic because it's not realistic. So we have to be comfortable having that pre-sex discussion, especially when you're just starting off. It's okay to tell someone you're a beginner. If they're turned off by that or put off by that, they're probably not the right sex partner for you. So tell someone that you're new and ask them to go slow and say, okay, let's do this together. Step three, you have to talk about douching. It's part of our world, it might not seem sexy, but you have to have it. So douching just means squirting a small amount of water up your butt and releasing it out. If you want to douche, that's fine. If you don't want to, that's fine. Now, if you want to, there's a couple different ways you can do it. And this is my go-to, and if I'm going to like a sex party or a circuit party, I keep this in like a drawstring bag with me. Most douches are actually gonna be a little bit smaller. This is the smaller version. Most douches look like this. Master that first. This is another kind of douche. It's just a simple shower shot. People who wanna play heavier or harder may have a longer attachment at the base, and this is actually gonna get up into the colons. It just cleans deeper. That is for pros. Don't try this when you're starting off. You want to take every step possible to minimize and quicken the douching process so that you're not keeping water up there, that you're releasing all of it, and that you're not irritating the good bacteria that exist in your rectum that often, because that can cause problems. Number four, bottoms, you got to take fiber. It's the most important meal of the day. The body has a natural way of cleaning out the colon, and that's by using the bathroom. Not everything goes out when you use the bathroom unless you actually change your diet and eat foods that are high fiber, that are not only better for your overall GI health, but are great for cleaning out and make cleaning out a lot easier. Step five, you have to talk about safety before you have gay sex. Ask HIV status, ask your status for other STIs. If you haven't been tested, tell them that. I'm HIV positive and undetectable. Undetectable means that medication makes the virus in my body unable to be transmitted. PrEP, pre-exposure prophylaxis, is also something that's changing the conversation. This is a daily medication that actually prevents the transmission of HIV with or without condoms. So if you're HIV negative and you're gonna be having any kind of sex, really consider getting on PrEP. I do have to say a quick word about playing on alcohol and drugs. Alcohol and drugs will impede your ability to read other people's body language and communicate as clearly as you could if you were sober. It might also hurt your ability to read your own pain. It makes you more likely to get hurt, and it sort of can create a situation where you need substances in order to enjoy your sex life. Know the risks before you play drunk or high. Step six, expect speed bumps. It's not gonna go the way you see it in porn. If you're a beginner bottom, you may not be able to dive into anal sex right away. And that's just a simple reality. It may not be that pleasurable. It may not really feel that good. It might be very uncomfortable. So you will have to just go with it and test the waters and see how it feels. Part of that is getting comfortable with foreplay, enjoying being around someone's presence. Tops, you have a job because you deliver the pleasure. You take the active role. Always talk and communicate, but sometimes, especially when it comes to reading pain, pain may be expressed non-verbally. He might wince or show signs of pain before he ever says it. You have to pay very special attention and close attention because this is someone that you care about. Seven, practice for tops and bottoms. A little bit of anatomy lesson. Your hole is actually a muscle. It's called the anal sphincter. It's actually one of the strongest muscles in the human body. And it's trained literally from birth to stay tight, clenched your entire life. Gay sex is difficult for beginners because they associate that muscle opening with having a bowel movement, with using the bathroom. That's why beginner bottoms say that the first or even first several times makes them feel like they have to take a shit. Training that muscle to open comfortably and learning to enjoy the feeling of that muscle opening takes some time. It takes practice. I find that the best practice for that doesn't come with just having more sex. It comes with using toys. So if you're a beginner bottom, my best advice is to buy a small, easy to take butt plug, very realistic in your size. Don't try to go for like a 10-inch diameter butt plug, my God. Start with a small one and generally actually work up in size. Get comfortable pulling it in and out or just keeping it in there, because that's gonna train your hole, your anal sphincter, to relax and open. And what you'll find after some practice is you'll actually realize that the feeling of it opening, it stops being painful, stops being uncomfortable, and becomes amazing. And I find that this is a really beautiful thing to do with a partner, actually. And I learned to enjoy butt plugs and learned to enjoy ass play and ass training with somebody else. And training together, loosening up together, learning to work your butt together, is actually one of the most intimate and awesome experiences you can have with someone you want to have sex with. Number 8, when you're new, you have to go slow. You're just simply not going to be able to have very fast, very rough sex when you start off. It took years of training, years of working up, years of learning my body, years of working with tops. I did not enjoy really rough sex until at least 3 years after my first gay sex experience. Number 9 is aftercare. Aftercare is something that kinky people talk about a lot, but aftercare applies in the most vanilla basic sex too. Aftercare for people who aren't using whips and chains and paddles simply means assessing the sex. Sitting down together and asking, how was that? How did it feel? What can I do differently? What should we try next time? When you're having that post-sex conversation, you don't want to say, you did this wrong. That's not the language you use. Simply say, I felt this way. It's not an appraisal of what someone else did. It's simply expressing how sex felt for you. Try everything twice, because sometimes there are just single one-off bad experiences. Step 10, have fun. Don't obsess over these when you're actually like doing it. Keep this in the back of your head, but there also isn't a guidebook. Have fun, figure it out, read their body. It's a beautiful journey.